So there are some realities to homesteading that you really need to understand if you're thinking about becoming a homesteader. Let's talk about those. So here's the first one, and the most exciting one, is that you do not need to start off in a fully functioning farm with everything set up already. You can start off with the minimal amount needed to get by. You can start off in an RV. There's plenty of people who do that. You can start off in a little yurt, a single wide trailer that you buy and you put on your property. It doesn't matter. What matters is that you get started. So you can see for us, behind us, if you haven't seen it before, is our house. It's small, it's modest, it's the perfect size for our family, it's just what we need, and we don't need anything else besides that. Now for us, we were blessed to have this barn and these stables on either side of it on the property when we got here, but you do not need to start off with something like that. You can absolutely start off with a small garden shed. You can absolutely start off with, say, a shipping container, which is, you know, middle of the road expensive. I think you can grab them for $2,000 or $3,000 delivered, and you can lock those up tight. You can store all your stuff in it just to get yourself established on your homestead. Even if you're going to be raising your own animals for, say, beef or chicken, whatever it is, you don't need to start off with a barn. There's plenty of people who keep their cows out in a pasture. They have maybe a small lean-to shelter for them. And if you have horses, you can do the same thing. We have this coop for our chickens. We do have another one, but this one is perfectly fine. They're out in the elements, but they're covered up. We've had some serious storms, hasn't bothered them at all. They're good to go. So you can start off with something just little and simple like this. Just get going. So I want to encourage you that you do not need to get all the tools and equipment, everything that you could possibly think of that you would need on a homestead. You do not have to get that right away, and you shouldn't. Build up slowly over time. For us, it took us several years to save up some money to get this tractor. And as you can see, it's a 20-year-old tractor, but she runs great and she does the job on our property. So if you've still got student loans like we did when we first got out here, or some other debt, work towards paying that off. Don't go hog wild, go into debt by getting items like this that you don't need really to start off. The important point is to start. Now, another myth I want to dispel is that you have to quit your job, run into the mountains, and start sawing logs for a log cabin by yourself. Some people can do that. It's fine for some people. But the reality is, in today's world, a lot of us have to keep our jobs. So for us, as you know, my wife works, I do YouTube, and I also do architecture from home. Homeschool the kids, but we're both working all the time, and we have to do that to be able to still afford this place, because we have a mortgage on it, we have vehicles, all that kind of stuff that we have to cover. Now, if you want to rough it, if you want to go hardcore, you can, but I want to caution you about doing that, because a lot of people who do that tend to get discouraged when things don't go their way. They don't or aren't able to produce enough food for themselves or their family right away, and boom, they're bouncing back to the suburbs or back to the city in just a few short years. So do not do that. Go at your own pace. Go at the pace that is proper for you, for your family, for your situation. So if you saw one of our recent videos, you saw this new little addition right here that we've added to the house. We have just been able to do that this year, and it's because we ran out of space, but we also did save money for it. We don't like to buy anything or add anything to our homestead unless we can afford to pay for it with cash. And I believe that that's really important in today's day and age. We're not tied to anybody. We're not in debt to anybody. Well, except for the house still, but that's getting knocked out pretty quick. And I want to really, really talk to you guys about just not going overboard on a homestead to begin with. Start small. Get a good amount of land that's going to suit you and that's going to be away from people and away from a lot of houses. But don't go crazy on a big old mansion on that country property, because you don't need it, and in the end, you can't take it with you. So another myth I want to dispel is that if you have a job and if you own a homestead and you're out on a country property, then you're not going to have to do much work out here and you can do some things, kind of like set it and forget it. Well, I'm here to tell you that is absolutely not true. So if you're working hard at a 9-to-5, you're still going to be putting in a ton of time to take care of your homestead. So I just want to prepare you for that. So if you need to change careers, if you need to downsize careers, if you can afford to do that, I absolutely would. But sometimes if you can't, you might be working two jobs and then coming back and doing another job here. So just keep that in mind. It is a ton of work. Be prepared to work. That is, unless you work yourself to the point of exhaustion where you can't even do anything anymore, just balance your life out and you'll be good to go. Now, another myth that I want to dispel is that you can't leave your homestead at all, that you're locked into it like a prison. And that is absolutely not true. We just took a 2-week long vacation. The important part is to set up systems, have systems in place, and those systems include, you know, automatic waters and feeders for your animals, or automatic watering system for your garden, and also setting up a group of friends, a community, to help you out when you're gone. And if you do that, you can absolutely take a vacation. We had 4 different friends come over and pick up eggs and check the cat's food and do all those things. Take care of the chicken food and all those while we were gone on our trip. And I did an entire video on that subject. You can check it out at the top of the screen. So there are tons of different ways to homestead, and don't get caught in a rut of thinking that you need to do it one way, like you see me doing it, or like you see Doug and Stacy doing it, or Wrangler Star doing it, or whomever else. It doesn't matter. Homestead how you need to homestead. The important part is that you just start. And in the world, in the way it's going, I encourage you to do that right now. And remember, no two homesteads are going to be the exact same, ever. Don't try to keep up with the Joneses. It's your journey. You do it how you need to do it. Now, there's some basics that you need to understand about homesteading and follow in on that homesteading trail, but it's your journey again. Do it. If these discussions are helpful for you, leave us a comment in the comment section below. Give us a like, subscribe to the channel. We'd love to have you here permanently. Now go check out these videos right here, which will be very helpful for you on your new homesteading journey. Have a great day. We'll see you next time. Bye.